Hello friends, this video on Human Reproduction Part 17 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Now, a very important question. What determines the sex of the baby? So how do you know that the baby which is being formed inside the body of the female is going to be a baby girl or a baby boy? So what determines the sex, whether it is a male or a female baby? Now, in many countries, you would have seen that people make a lot of fuss out of the gender of the baby. Some people say that we want a baby boy, so we are not ready to have a baby girl. Some people blame the females, I mean the mothers, that they gave birth to a baby girl. So things like that keep happening in a lot of places. So let us try to understand what actually determines that whether the baby will be a girl or a boy. So this is something interesting. Now, in order to understand this, you should have some basic knowledge of the human chromosomes. However, you have this knowledge because we have discussed this in class 10. But still, just for a quick recap, let's talk about human chromosomes. Now, inside the human body, each and every cell of our body contains 46 chromosomes. So they are all diploid cells. All the cells of the body are diploid cells. That is, they have 46 chromosomes, or you can say they have 23 pairs of chromosomes, right? So these are the 46 chromosomes which are present in each and every cell of the body. Now, out of these 46 chromosomes, 44 of them are autosomes. That is, 22 pairs are autosomes. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, as you see, till 22, they are all autosomes. What is the meaning of autosomes? That means they are similar in a male and a female. So all these chromosomes will be the same whether the gender is a male or a female. Doesn't matter. But the last pair, that is the 23rd pair, which you see here, this is going to be different in a male and a female. So if this is XX, then it is going to be a female. If this chromosome is going to be a XY, then it is going to be a male. So if the person is male, in that case, his sex chromosome is going to be XY. And if the person is going to be a female, then the sex chromosome is going to be XX. So this is this chromosome, and that is why this 23rd pair of chromosome is called the sex chromosome. So this chromosome will define whether an individual is a male or a female. Right? So till here it is clear. So now the question is, when fertilization happens, that time one, what happens actually? Two haploid cells. One is the sperm, the other one is the ovum. So the sperm is donated by the father, the ovum is donated by the mother. Both are haploid, so they have half the number of chromosomes. So they do not have 46 chromosomes, rather they have 23 each. Correct? So now let us see how the combination decides whether the sex chromosome of the baby will be that of a male or a female. So let us see how the sex is finally determined. Now, as I mentioned in the previous slide, that females have a perfect pair of sex chromosome. That is, the sex chromosome in female is XX. So the mother will donate, the mother will give her haploid nucleus. That means that she is going to donate half the number of chromosomes. 23 chromosomes is going to come from the mother, and in those 23 chromosomes, 22 will be autosomes and there will be one sex chromosome. So what is that sex chromosome that is going to come from the mother? Since the mother has XX, so that one sex chromosome that is going to come from the mother has to be X only, because she has XX, right? On the other hand, males have mismatched pair of sex chromosome, that is XY. So even the father will donate or contribute 23 chromosomes, out of which 22 will be autosomes and one will be sex chromosome. Now this sex chromosome in case of the father can be an X or a Y, because the father has XY, that is dissimilar chromosomes, but mother has XX. Now, when the fusion happens, these two will combine. So what are the possibilities? The father can donate either X or Y, but the mother will always donate X. So that means this X can, if father donates X, then this X can combine with this X. So what will be formed? XX. If father donates Y, but mother donates X, then what will happen? it will be XY. If father donates X, mother also donates X, again XX. If father donates Y and mother donates X, again XY. So that means there is 50% possibility that the baby will have XX, and there is 50% possibility that the baby will have XY. And if it is XX, that means it is a baby girl. If it is XY, that means it is a baby boy. Now, in this case, what do you think? The mother in both the cases, whether it is a girl or a boy, X is coming from the mother. So the mother is donating the same thing. But who is donating different things? That is father. If the father donates Y, it is going to be a boy. If the father donates X, it is going to be a girl. So who determines the sex of the baby? It is not the mother but the father. So when this X and the Y chromosome, as I said, the egg will always have X, but the sperm can have either X or Y. So if these two combine, it will be a girl. If these two combine, then it will be a boy. So a father determines whether the child will be a baby girl or a baby boy. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.